Okay, well, the first thing I want to talk about this month is practicing. We can't get good at playing the violin unless we practice. And it takes a lot of practice to get good at playing the violin. So we need to discuss this subject. A lot of people don't like to practice and they don't want to practice, and they're very good at making excuses for why they can't practice, okay? So we're going to talk about the two main excuses that I hear for not practicing. Number one is, I don't have enough time. I can only practice once a week and I just don't have time to do anymore. The second excuse that I hear a lot of is, the violin's too loud, okay? So it bothers other people in my house, so I can't practice. That one I can actually really understand, because the violin is a loud instrument. So we're going to talk about that in just a minute here. But first of all, I want to talk about the first excuse. And that is, a lot of us, yes, we have busy schedules, but you can make time to practice. You only need 15 minutes a day. Just 15 minutes a day, you can make huge progress with your playing. A lot of people don't realize that. You just think, well, if I only have 15 minutes, then it's not worth it. You know, I can't accomplish anything in 15 minutes. Why bother? I'm just not going to practice today. I'll make up for it on Saturday. Maybe I'll practice for 2 hours on Saturday or something like that. But actually, you can make more progress if you practice in just 15 minutes a day, 5 days a week, than if you practice for 2 hours on Saturday. You're going to make more progress with small amounts of practice daily, because then you can build on it each day. And all of us can make 15 minutes of time. I don't want to hear any excuses with that one. We can all make 15 minutes. I mean, you can just, maybe you need to get up 15 minutes earlier if that's what you need to do. But we can make 15 minutes of time. And I used to think too that you needed to spend at least an hour to make any progress, that 15 minutes wasn't worth it. But then one year, I overpracticed. I had a lot of concerts and things that I had to play in that year, and I overpracticed and I hurt my shoulder because I played too much. I was playing about 6 hours a day. And so I injured myself, and for about 2 months I could barely play at all. I actually had to take some time where I pretty much didn't play. But I had a big concert coming up in the fall, and I really needed to be spending time practicing that summer. So what I started doing is I just practiced 15 minutes a day. That's all I could handle, was 15 minutes before the shoulder would just start hurting way too bad. So I thought, well, I'm going to take those 15 minutes. It's better than nothing. And it was a huge discovery for me, because I was making more progress in that 15 minutes a day than I had been making in about 2 hours of practice before. That was just incredible to me. Why? It was because I was focused for that whole 15 minutes. I knew I only had 15 minutes, so I wasn't going to waste a single second of that time. I was focused and very involved in my practicing. I wasn't doing any daydreaming or getting distracted. I was very focused on what I was doing. And so that just made a big progress in improvement in my playing. It was just incredible. So the 15 minutes a day is, it's not a waste of time. It's a very good practicing technique. Much better than doing it 6 hours a day. Then you're just going to end up hurting yourself like I did. So now let's talk about the next excuse, and that's that the violin's too loud. You know, sometimes in order to get your practicing time in that day, you might have to practice at night or in the morning, and maybe other people are sleeping. So that can be a problem, because this is a loud instrument. So we're going to talk about mutes for just a few minutes here, because that can really help. There's a few different types of mutes, and some of them are better than others. You just have to choose what works for you. The first type of mute is a small mute, and these are used in orchestra. They just slip over your strings, and they just ride there on your violin when you're not using them, and they're out of your way. And then when you are ready to use them, like sometimes in a classical piece for, you know, several majors, maybe they want the violins to be quiet, so you slip your mute on over the bridge like that, and then it dampens the strings and makes them quieter. And then when you're done, you just slip it off. So we're going to just talk about these mutes, and we'll talk about this one first. First of all, I'm just going to play the violin. I'm going to play our D major scale, which we're going to be working on in a couple minutes. I'm going to play it with no mute on, so you can hear the contrast. Okay, now let's put our orchestra mute on and listen to the difference. So it made it a little bit quieter. But those, it's just a little bit, so it's not really that good for practicing if you really need to make your violin a lot quieter. Next type of mute we have is a rubber mute. These are fairly inexpensive that you can buy. And this one slips over the whole bridge, like so. And as you can see, pretty much covers up my bridge, and it's gonna make that one, it's gonna make it a lot quieter than that first mute did. But it's actually still fairly loud, even with a lot of people have these ones, and I still feel like I can make quite a bit of noise when I'm using that for practicing. So it helps, but it's still kind of loud. So if you need it to be even quieter than that, then you can buy a metal mute. They're still fairly inexpensive. And these ones, it's pretty heavy. This one will make a lot bigger difference. My bow out of the way. You slip this one over the bridge. It doesn't fit all the way over the bridge. It just sits up on top of it. Now listen to this difference. So that one really quiets the violin down. So if you need to be quiet when you play, I'd recommend one of these metal mutes. And that will help you a lot, okay? So those are the two main excuses I hear. And so you have no excuse to practice. If you don't have a lot of time, just 15 minutes a day will do. If you need to get your violin quieter, then buy one of those practice mutes, and that'll really help you out, okay?